Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use the touch type tool in Adobe Illustrator. Now, this is just only one of over 90 free tutorials I've posted on YouTube, and I want to invite you to check those out and to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so you don't miss any of my future tutorials. Illustrator's touch type tool makes it super easy to make changes to individual letters that are in your text without converting them to outlines. And the advantage here is not only are you able to change the color and the shape of your text, you can also come back and even change the font. This is a fun little tool to play with, and I think you're really going to enjoy it. So let's move over to another document and get started. Now, I've saved a small copy of the type we had on the first page because I'm going to show you how I made that. But for now, let's talk about the touch type tool itself. It's a part of the text flyout menu, and it's found on the left toolbar. Come over to the T, click down with your mouse, hold it, and you have the flyout menu. And at the bottom, we see the touch type tool. The easiest way to access this is with the keyboard shortcut Shift T. So I'm going to click on here, and we see the tool is active because I have that little icon attached to my cursor. Now, to use the touch type tool, we've got to select an individual character. So I'm going to click on the T, and immediately we have this character box surrounding my selected letter. And I have these little five action buttons, four on the box and one above it. And each one has a special function. So I'll start with the top left, and as I drag it up or drag it down, it's going to change the vertical scale of my text, but it doesn't change the baseline. Now, what's a baseline? Well, it's the invisible line that your text is sitting on. So the T has been changed vertically, but it's still at that same baseline as the rest of my letters. Now I'll click on the O, and I'll come to the bottom right corner, and I'm going to drag either to the right or to the left to change the horizontal scale. And again, we still have that same baseline. Now I'll move to the U and select it, and I'll move up to the top right, and you can see my cursor now has the diagonal lines, and that's showing me that I'm able to scale horizontally and vertically at the same proportion, and this is what I end up with. Now I'll click on the C and come down to the bottom left. Now this button looks different than the other three. It's filled in, which indicates that it is always selected. Now this is the button that changes the baseline, and what we can do is either use the up arrow key to move the baseline up or the down arrow key to move the baseline down. I can also use my mouse and click anywhere in the character box and just drag it up to move the baseline up or drag it down to move it down. Now, one thing you need to know is that with the touch type tool, you're not able to hold down the shift key to drag in a perfect vertical line. So you're really better off if you want it to go straight up or down to use that arrow key. And you're actually not limited to moving up and down. You can also move to the right or to the left. If I press the right arrow key, I'm moving to the right, and with the left arrow key, I move to the left. The thing to know is that when you move the selected character, all of the other characters are going to shift as well. So here's what that means. If I use my mouse and I drag the C to the right, all of the text that's to the right of the C moved as a group with the C, and all the text that's to the left of the C moved in a group, and it moved as far to the left as the C did to the right. So what that means is if you want to move your letters and let's say overlap them, you've got to be very strategic. It's not hard to do. You just need to understand how these letters are going to move. So what I need to do if I want my letters to overlap is start at the left. Now I want to overlap the T, so I'm going to start with the second letter. I'll select it and just drag to the left. Now the T's moving a little forward, but that's okay. I'm able to manage it, and when I have the overlap I want, I'll just stop moving and click on the U and drag it to the left. Now I can tell that I'm overlapping the O, and did you notice all of the letters which were to the right of the U are moving with them. Next I'll select the C and drag, and it's easier to see the letters moving here. And then finally we'll drag the H over, and it's overlapping. Now I have a space in between the H and the T, so I'm not going to be able to overlap the H, but I wouldn't want to do that anyway. So I'm going to grab the T, just move it slightly to the left, and then move the Y and overlap it, come over to the P. And once you understand how the letters are going to move, it's really not hard at all. Now let's come back over and select this O, and we'll talk about what we have down below here later on. I want to focus on the O and on the last action button, which is centered above the character box, and this is the rotate button. And what I'll do is hover over the button until I see the rotate icon, and then I'll press down with my mouse and drag either to the left or to the right. And notice as I'm dragging, the letters to the right and the left of the rotating object are moving as well. And we're not going to worry about that now. I'm going to get the rotation first, and then we'll move those letters back the way we want them. So when I have the letter the way I want it, I'm going to release my mouse, and you can see the rotation that we end up with. Again, with the touch type tool, the shift key isn't going to work. So I can't hold the shift key down and snap to 45-degree increments as I rotate, but I am able to see the rotation in the text box that's to the right of my cursor. I'm going to release my mouse, and then I'll move my O back to the left, and then grab the U, and when I move the U, all of the other letters are going to move along with it, and the letters are back where I want them to be. Now, in addition to moving each one of these characters, we can also change their attributes individually. So I'm going to select this U and come over to the Properties panel and click on the Color Fill icon. I'll change the color of the fill, and I can change the color of the stroke. I can also change the opacity, but I'm going to move that back to 100%, and I can even change the font. So I'll come down and click on the pull down menu, and we'll change this to Market Pro, and then click on the artboard to deselect that. Now come back over and click on the O and explain this down below. When you have a letter selected and you see a block of color and these letters down below, these are glyphs that are associated with this particular letter. Not all letters are going to have glyphs, all numbers do. Now they're more helpful probably with numbers, because when you click on a glyph with a number, you're going to be able to use it for a footnote. You can play around with these and see if any of them are useful to you, but for now, I'm just going to undo that move, keyboard shortcut Command Z. I'll click on the artboard to close that out, and now I'm going to take these letters and turn them into these letters, which you saw at the beginning of the video. So the first thing I'll do is click on the T. I'll move over to the Properties panel, and I'm going to click on the pull-down menu and change the letter to Brim Narrow Combined, and this is a pretty good size here, but it looks wider in the sample. So I'll drag the bottom right corner a little bit to the right. I'll leave this orange, then I'll click on the O. We're going to change the color, and then I'm going to drag this up and to the left, and it looks about right. Now select the U, and it's the right font but the wrong color, so I'll click on the color fill icon and choose the blue. I'm going to change the stroke back to black. And then I'm going to change the height and drag it over on top of the O a little bit more. And then select the C, change the color. And we're going to rotate this a little bit to the left. And then drag it, move it over the O. And then for the H, I'll change the color, and then change the size and drag it up and over a little bit, and then select the T, change the color, and change the font, and then increase the size. That seemed just a little big. We'll come back down a little bit here, And then click on the Y, change the color. This needs to rotate, come to the right, and drag this to the left and raise it up just a little bit. And this needs to actually be a little smaller, so we'll reduce the size here. Then I'll select the P. We're going to change the font to Market Pro, leave the color the same, and drag it up. And this is maybe a little thinner and a little shorter. Drag this up and then select the E, change the color, and this is quite a bit smaller. I'll drag this here. And that's fairly close. I think this might need to be a little skinnier here. And I could keep playing around with some of these letters because this is such a fun tool to work with, but I'm going to call it finished. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video and learning about the touch type tool. It's not a tool you'll use in every project, but when you're looking for something that's kind of fun or has a little pop, maybe this will be your go-to tool. I want to remind you to subscribe to my channel and click that notification bell so you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.